Oh, don't play dumb. You know exactly what you did. Delete the post right now!
My ex-husband, Tom, finally seems to have realized about my revenge. I created a video to reply for my ex-husband's video, which is named as "The Useless Wife Messed Up My Lunch, So I'm Throwing It Away Again Today." And I tagged this under my video named as "Will the Lunch Be Thrown Away by My Ex-Husband Again Today?" The Very Tasty Lunch, which was made by my mother-in-law. My name is Lauren. I have been married for 1 year to my husband, Tom. I had no doubt that we were still newlyweds and would enjoy our days together as a husband and wife. But unfortunately, the reality is cruel. About 6 months into our marriage, my husband's work suddenly became very busy. And so, I spent more and more time at home alone. I also have a job and work at a company. It is very possible for office workers like my husband and I to suddenly become very busy, and that is why I could not notice my husband's strange attitude and actions at all. In addition, since my husband started working very hard, my mother-in-law, Susan, started coming to our house unannounced more often, and I was just busy dealing with her. I would usually come home around 7 p.m. And as I got home from work, Susan's unannounced visits would begin again like a daily routine. The doorbell would ring. I look at my watch and see that it is 7:15 p.m. I have a feeling that she must have been waiting for me somewhere. "You came home late again today, didn't you?" We live a bit far from my office, so it's inevitable that I get home around this time.
"Is Tom working late again today?"
"Yes, he has been doing overtime for some time now."
"So it's just you and I once again, huh?"
Well, Susan, if you want to see your son, Tom, how about you coming over on the weekend from now on?"
"I didn't say I didn't want to be alone with you."
"Yes, but I have told you every time you come here to please contact me in advance if you're coming over. I also have a lot to prepare for when you come here."
"Oh, that's fine. I don't want you to just prepare for me in particular. Besides, I have to make sure that Tom eats something nutritious. I made it again today, so please make sure Tom eats it, okay?"
"I understand." My mother-in-law is a reliable mother who raised my husband and my brother-in-law all by herself, so I respect her for that. However, I think she may be over-interfering. I am married after all, and I don't think that I'm bad at cooking. Susan would come over to our house twice a week and leaves a lot of dishes she has cooked. Well, she doesn't charge us for the ingredients, and the food tastes really good. And my mother-in-law is making my share of the food too. Even though I was feeling a little uneasy about it, I decided to think that she was worried about her son.
"I'm home."
I looked at the clock and saw that it was around 11 p.m. "Welcome home. Have you eaten?"
"I've eaten. I'm going to take a shower and go to bed."
"Okay, good night." Lately, we don't have more than 5 minutes of conversation a day. My husband doesn't talk to me much anymore, probably because he is just exhausted. It's hard for me to try to talk to him when he shows signs that he is clearly exhausted like that. I wonder how long this kind of life will continue. I felt uneasy about our relationship. One day, on his day off, my husband left the house early because he had to work on his day off. Then I received a call from one of my friend, Anna. "Are you free today?" "Yes, I am. I'm so free. Can I come over to your house?" "Of course, you are more than welcome." Half an hour later, Anna came over to my house to visit me. She has known me since we were in college, and we've become such good friends that we go out for dinner once every 2 weeks. "How are you?" What are you saying all of a sudden? "Of course I'm fine." "I see. Hey, what is it?" "Well, I'm just going to say it plainly. I found your husband, Tom's social media."
"What?
I don't think Tom does that kind of thing, though." "I know, right? But anyway, look at this.
Anna then showed me the screen of her phone. And when she played back the video, I saw a lunchbox, which looked really familiar to me. I also recognized the watch which was shown through the man's suit. But once I saw the title of the video, I completely turned pale. The title of the video was, Useless Wife Who Makes Disgusting Meals and Lunch. I'm throwing it away today too. I was absolutely completely mortified.
Oh my god. This is Tom. Right? This is going pretty viral, you know.
Are you serious? Oh yeah, you're right. It looks like Tom has a lot of followers. When I took a closer look at the content of Tom's social media site, I could see that he calls it a way to relieve stress over his wife's bad cooking habits. And he goes into great detail about the contents of his lunch and showing how he actually trashes the lunches right into the trash.
And isn't Tom coming home late these days?
Excuse me? Well, yes, for the past 6 months or so. He has been busy all of a sudden.
Well, he's probably not working overtime. I think he's having an affair.
What?
It's this person, you know. She's commenting on his videos frequently.
I checked the woman's account. Then, there are a bunch of posts about them eating the same food at the same time. After seeing that, I knew that Tom surely was cheating on me. How did you find out?
Well, it's my job, you know.
Oh yeah, that's right. Anna happens to be in the web marketing department and does a lot of market research. She was searching for posts that had recently been going viral and increasing views on videos, and happened to come across my husband's social networking site. I thanked Anna about her information and headed to a private investigator's office. When I showed the video of my husband's social media to the owner of the investigator's office, he said,
"Your husband needs to be sanctioned."
I signed a contract with the investigator on the same day. A week later, I received the investigation result, and I confirmed with them that the social media belonged to my husband and that he was cheating on me. I had no choice but to divorce him. When he threw away the lunch, that's just unbelievable. But that alone was not enough to blame my husband for our marriage. Now that I have the result, I can play the perfect game against him. From there, I spent the next 2 weeks preparing for the divorce in various ways. Then, on the day of the first match between my husband, he ended up coming home early. The reason why for this is because I had earnestly told him that I had something important to discuss with him. My husband must have probably felt guilty about something. He came home without any hesitation, and he asked me right away what it was about.
What do you want to talk about?
Wait here for a minute. Susan will be here soon too. My husband somehow looked really nervous. He must have sensed something. Then my mother-in-law arrived. Now that all the members for this meeting are here, I will tell you the reason why I called you both here today. I am divorcing Tom.
What?
My husband's mouth was wide open, in shock.
What do you mean divorce?
It's because I thought I couldn't continue my marriage with Tom anymore.
What? Is it because I work late and do overtime? If you're a wife, you should put up with that much at least.
At that point, my husband must have decided that he wasn't being discovered. So that's why he was suddenly being very aggressive.
Well, can you take a look at this?
Saying that, I put the report which I received from the private investigator in front of them. At that moment, my husband, perhaps in a hurry, snatched the report away.
What the hell is this? Did you hire somebody to research about me?
That's right.
I told you, I was working overtime, didn't I?
Overtime, huh? Oh, so you were with a woman named Meredith every day around that time, and that's what you call overtime, huh?
Tom, hurry up and hand me that report right this instant.
Angered by his own mother, my husband reluctantly handed the report to her. Then, after a while, Susan started to tremble.
Your lunch?
That's right. Mom, I can't eat Lauren's cooking, you know.
My husband, perhaps thinking that Susan had taken his side, continued to show his stubborn attitude.
If you want a divorce, then fine. I don't mind getting a divorce. But since you're the one who caused it, I won't pay you any alimony.
Even though you're cheating on me with Meredith?
I cheated on you because your cooking is just so bad.
That's enough.
Yeah, that's right. You think that your cooking is amazing, huh? Well, you should just taste and find out how disgusting they are, and don't just blame me for it. Seriously, that's enough.
But the next moment, my husband took a huge slap to his face.
I was saying it to you! That's enough!
Oh, Mom?
First of all, you better get down on your knees and apologize to Lauren here. Think about the feelings of your own wife who never doubted you and always waited for you to come back home. You stupid son!
Susan stormed up to my husband, who had a really red cheek because of the slap he took, and she pulled him down by the neck, forcing him to sit on his knees. Then Susan also sat upright and looked straight at me.
I'm terribly sorry, Lauren.
And saying that, Susan apologized to me. She also grabbed Tom's head and rubbed it against the floor at the same time.
Plus, the lunches that you said, which are disgusting, are the ones I made for you.
What?
When my mother-in-law told him the truth, my husband began to tremble.
I'm really sorry, Mom. I didn't know you made them for me, Mom.
My mother-in-law glared at my husband sharply.
You're not allowed to throw any food away, no matter who made it.
Yes, I'm sorry.
And you had the outrageous nerve to videotape it and show it to the world. And on top of that, you cheat on your wife. You're doing the same thing that your own father did and making the wife sad. Shame on you. I am so ashamed of you.
Is that why you had a divorce, Susan?
Yes. I couldn't forgive my husband, you see. And I didn't tell my son the exact reason about it. I never thought he would do the same thing.
I see. Well, I have no choice but to divorce Tom.
And that can't be helped. It's what my son did, and he can never take back what he had done.
Susan looked very sad as she said this.
Wait a minute. I'm apologizing right now, right? I won't do it again.
Who can believe what Tom says now? And we're talking about my husband here. He's probably refusing to get a divorce because he thinks he's going to have to pay a huge alimony bill for what he did. Oh, don't worry. I won't ask for alimony. We've only been married for a year, so even if I did, it wouldn't be much.
Really?
His eyes were shining as he said that. Yeah, I won't. So please don't charge me anything in the future either.
I won't. I understand.
I knew it. He didn't care about the divorce, but he just didn't want to pay alimony. My husband just apologized as a short-term solution. We then divorced, and I demanded $10,000 in alimony from Tom's mistress, and confirmed that it had been transferred the other day. Susan kept on apologizing to me until the very end. Although Susan was the one who kept on coming over unannounced frequently, I have no grudge against her at all. I hope she will continue to live well. Susan was so furious about this incident that when my husband went to his own parents' house, they refused to let him in. But Susan has another son and his family who was really caring. I am glad that she has people who can relate to her feelings, which were hurt by Tom. But it would be a little while before I would regain my peaceful life. I waited for the second match to come. 2 weeks later, my ex-husband finally seemed to realize the revenge I had taken. That day, I was bombarded with phone calls from the morning. It was all from my ex-husband, of course.
I slowly sipped my freshly brewed coffee and answered the phone.
Hey, you've got to be kidding me. Can't you even tell the difference between what's right and wrong?
What are you talking about?
Oh, don't play dumb. You know exactly what you did. Delete the post right now. Otherwise, I'll charge you with compensation.
My ex-husband, Tom, finally seems to have realized about my revenge. I created a video to reply for my ex-husband's video, which is named as "The Useless Wife Messed Up My Lunch, So I'm Throwing It Away Again Today." And I tagged this under my video named as "Will the lunch be thrown away by my husband again today? The very tasty lunch which was made by my mother-in-law." In that video, the lunch that Susan made for Tom was neatly being packed into his lunchbox for the morning. Then, not knowing about this, Tom posts a video of the exact same lunch, only he was being terrible about it and expressing how disgusted he was by it and how he threw them away in one long video. We live in this day and age. It is easy for people who use the internet to tie the two videos together. My video attracted voices defending me, while my ex-husband's video was harshly criticized. It got so viral that my ex-husband deleted all of his videos, but it was already too late. The archives are probably still all over the place. And just as I had planned, my ex-husband was fired from the company. My stupid ex-husband, unaware that his video contained a document with the company's symbolic logo, posted the video and viewers discovered about it. It became a big deal, since viewers even identified the company he was working at. And I knew this would all happen, because my friend Anna told me about it. You really should have friends.
You better pay me compensation.
You promised during the divorce that you wouldn't charge me anything in the future, no matter what.
Well, I didn't think you'd do this to me.
Oh, I see. Fine then, sue me. I'll fight you. I'll submit everything you did as evidence. And if I have to pay for it, that's fine too. I don't want any money. Even if the jury decides that I'm not good enough, I'm fine with that because I definitely know that I did the right thing. My ex-husband had lost his temper at first, but by the time I finished what I was saying, he was crying. Well, that's right. He had joined the company of his dreams since he was a child and was leading a smooth sailing life, but he had destroyed it all by himself. There is no room for sympathy. However, this time, I was able to do what I did because my ex-mother-in-law agreed to it. I had given my ex-mother-in-law the details of what my revenge and plans were in advance, knowing that she would refuse. If my ex-mother-in-law said no, I was not going to carry out this revenge. However, my ex-mother-in-law told me to do it, and I was able to carry out this revenge without any issues. Moreover, from being criticized by the lunch incident, Tom was even exposed to the public that he had cheated on me, and even the person with whom he had cheated on had been identified, and she also received severe criticism and bullying from the internet. At first, the woman was posting comments saying that there was something wrong with me, the wife, but before I knew it, the woman's account had been deleted. Being happy with how everything turned out in the end, I deleted the video. Some of you may think I went too far, but that's okay. There are all kinds of people in the world with all kinds of ideas. I am the type that if you get hit, you hit back. Wow, there are all kinds of people in the world. And please, don't waste any food. Tom destroyed his own dream with his own hands. But why can't I feel sorry for him? I guess I also am the same type as Lauren. Thank you for watching to the end. Please subscribe to our channel if you like. See you in the next video!